So and although the Berlin WASG is not a Marxist party, it took a clear class standpoint, not at least because of our involvement, by clearly placing itself on the side of the working class, on the unemployed people. And the SAV made an important contribution politically and legally, ensuring that the WASG could stand in the election. The SAV also laid the political foundation for me as a top candidate to be invited to several talk shows and to have the possibility to talk to a mass audience. For instance, I was one talk show which has over 4 million viewers. And the consequence of this talk show was that one of the leading PDS politicians was Gregor Gysi. I don't know if anybody of you know him. He refused to appear in same talk shows as me because they argued that the WASG and especially the SAB are splitting the left with the election campaign in Berlin. But we repeatedly emphasize that left unity is only possible on the basis of left policy, and that the policies of the PDS in Berlin is, they are not left, but they are anti-social. So we just said that the PDS talks about socialism on Sunday, but they're carrying out social cuts from Monday to Saturday. And I think in the election campaign we showed very clearly that the WASG is something fundamentally different. So at the initiative of the SAB, the WASG supported the strike of the hospital workers at the Charité. We also organized a campaign against privatization of public houses by the SPD and PDS. And apart from that, we organized an action outside a posh restaurant themed Eat Like the Rich for Once. So we distributed thousands of flyers in front of job centers and invited all the unemployed of Berlin to come and eat like the rich in the posh restaurant at the boss's expense. And the flyer, which we distributed, also said that the WASG will make sure that the money is collected from those who owe it. So we just planned to go the day after the action. We wanted to go to the Senator of Finances and to the employer organization to get the money back. So it's a pity that it's not the time to tell what really happened. So we can have it later. So, but the election campaign manager of the PDS, Ramelow, he accused me and the Berlin WASG of wanting to build a party of street fighters. He said, okay, what a compliment, because to be a party of street fighters meant, for instance, that half of the strike leaders from the Charité were at the WASG election party, and made very clear that we are quite different to the other parties. Yeah, as Joe already mentioned, we were supported by WASG members from all over Germany and by a very large number of SAV members, but also from comrades from the international. And I want to, I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Irish comrades for their contribution, for their practical help and fly posting. The posters on the one hand, but also for the political contribution. For example, Matt reported on the Gamma strike at a large WASG meeting, and it gave many WASG members an idea of the role which a member of parliament, the support of a real fighting party, could play in winning improvements for the working class. And I think it's no exaggeration to say that without SAV and the experience and support from the CWI, this kind of election campaign would not have been possible. So, and you can applaud for yourself now. In contrast to us, Linkstruck, that's a sister organization of the SWP in Germany, they played quite catastrophic
role. So they supported the PDS in the election campaign, and they were in favor of the suspension of the regional committee in Berlin. So they supported the so-called lesser evil position, which we consistently opposed to. The SWP always argued for an abstract unity, which was for them more important than the political program. But that was not the unity, for instance, together the unity with the Charité workers or the workers at Bosch Siemens, but what they meant was the unity to, with the leaders of the PDS who were responsible for the wage cuts at the Charité, for example. So there were, on the other hand, other left organizations who criticized the WASG in Berlin from the left and also the SAV. And, but they only presented their own program and thereby isolating themselves from the working class. And I think we were the only socialist organization who fought for influence in the working class through our involvement in the Berlin WASG and at the same time bringing a clear political program and socialist ideas into the WASG and fighting for them. And it's interesting that now after the election campaign there's the debate amongst the WASG member started whether the Berlin WASG should now take up a socialist program. So there's a debate on socialism now at the conclusion of the development of the PDS. And I think that this proved that we have done it the right way. So I have 3 minutes left, I think. So comrades, we did not manage to reach the 5% barrier in Berlin because many people just said that they like us, but they don't think that, or they say they have no guarantee that we are really different from the other parties. And for this reason, I think we have to prove now, during the next few months, that we are fundamentally different. And we have just begun to do that. We, 2 days after the election campaign, we participated again in the strike at the Charité. At the hospital, and the workers were very surprised why we turn up again because the election campaign is over now, so why are you here? So it was quite good, and we played a very crucial role at the Bosch Siemens strike. Today in 5 cities in Germany there are demonstrations by the trade unions, Congress by the TUC against social cuts, and the motto of the demonstration is that can be done better. So we think that Hartz IV can't be done better, so our motto is that can only be done completely differently, and we will participate with a block on our own. So I have to shorten a bit. So on the future of the new party and the party in Berlin, we say very clearly that we are not prepared to merge the PDS in Berlin, and that we defend the independence of the Berlin WASG. But the SAV will continue to get involved in the process on a national scale, and we will lead a campaign for a no vote in the members' ballot on the merger of the PDS, which takes place next year, if certain minimum conditions on political content are not met. So despite this, despite our no vote campaign, we expect the merger to go ahead, as not in Berlin, but on a national scale. And I think it's clear that the phase which began with the foundation of the WASG, in which there was an enthusiastic feeling that this was a new departure, a new party, has come to an end now, or in the next half year. And that also means that the first stage in the process of building a new workers' party is therefore over, because the merged party will also complicate the process which is taking place No, but we have to conclude that the developments show that new Workers' Party do not fall just from the sky. So, and it's important to understand that in Germany the WASG developed right at the beginning of a phase of generalized class struggles, and this gives a preview of what development new formation will take when the class struggle intensifies and what Marxists like we could play in such a period. Thank you.
Absolutely outstanding role in the election struggle and in bringing the ideas of genuine socialism to a really mass audience in Germany for the first time in decades in reality.